Yeah. You're working with a film.
I am.
And I wanted you to tell us a little bit about that.
I'm producing a film with my friend Dennis Prager and Adam Carolla, my friends. It's called No Safe Spaces. And we're about three quarters done shooting. We've done a lot of interviews with some great people like Alan Dershowitz and Jordan Peterson, Van Jones, people on the right, left, center, all over the political spectrum. But I'm really looking forward to our next phase. We're going to shoot actors playing young Adam Carolla and young Dennis Prager, recreations of their early years and important moments in their life. And we'll all throw that into a blender and come out with a docudrama, we call it.
Awesome. That's incredible.
Now, you got another documentary that you're working on that should be coming out to us down the road that's kind of gotten a lot of buzz, at least on social media, and it's Safe Spaces that you've been working on.
No Safe Spaces.
No Safe Spaces. Right. Thank you for that clarification. How's that project going? Where are you at with it? What's it about?
It's going well. I'm so excited to work with Adam Carolla. I've known Adam for a couple of years, but this is the first time to work with him, and he's such a character. And then he brought along Dennis Prager, who's Dennis is, of course, a conservative talk show host, and Adam is kind of Adam's a libertarian-ish atheist. Kind of funny comedian guy. Uh-huh. So it's this really, in a way, kind of an odd couple of the elder statesman who's, has a conservative talk show and then Adam. But I think they've come together on this issue, that this is really an issue that really should unite right and left. It's not really a partisan issue. We should all be in favor of free speech. Mm-hmm. And the notion that on college campuses you can't speak your mind or you have to have safe spaces, this should really be upsetting. And it is upsetting. I've noticed, especially on the political left, I've noticed a lot of people saying, listen, I'm not down with this. I understand that where they're going, but this is not what we fought for in the 60s. This is not what we were aiming for. And again, similar to the Japan documentary, this is also a canary in the coal mine moment, because if this continues, mm-hmm. if this ethos spreads into society, because these college students, unless we can get to them and really push back, they're going to be city planners one day. They're going to be mm-hmm. politicians one day. They'll be Supreme Court justices one day. Mm-hmm. And if this ethos that you have to protect people from a certain point of view spreads, then we're going to have safe spaces in cities. We'll have this part of town where you can't say this mm-hmm. word, this mm-hmm. part of town where you can. And that's not really what we're about.
Well, yeah, I don't think America was founded on the concept of criminalizing political speech. I mean, right. in fact, it was the opposite of that. So how are you going to use that documentary in a way to change those hearts and those minds of those college kids?
Yeah, we really want to, first of all, show what's going on and let people speak about what they think in this area. And there are people that genuinely want to limit free speech mm-hmm. and things you shouldn't say certain things. Mm-hmm. And then we want to go to solutions and also remind us of the obvious, which is, you know, the whole point of freedom of speech is to protect offensive speech.
Right.
Good speech doesn't need to be protected.
Right.
It's to protect the crazy person, the crazy Klansman, or whatever mm-hmm. it might be that we right. don't agree with. And in some ways, I think, you know, sunlight is the best disinfectant. It's mm-hmm. almost better to have racist views and opinions happening in the culture so they can be answered. When they're squelched, they're not answered, mm-hmm. then they can tend to grow. Mm-hmm. And so I feel like offensive speech needs to be out there and needs to be answered quickly. And effectively.
Well, yeah, and I don't really like the idea of somebody deciding what is offensive and what isn't, because where does it end? What's the limit on that?
Well, that's how we figure that out by dialoguing with each mm-hmm. other, right? That's how
right.
we find out these views are extreme or these are, because we have to answer them. And so, mm-hmm. and also we have to be confident in our views. You know, part mm-hmm. of this is a lack of confidence on the
right.
part of young people
yeah.
feeling like my views can't really stand the test of being debated back and forth, and so I'm going to protect them. And we have to be confident and robust. And if we have wrong views, we need to change our views, right? That's the mm-hmm. whole point of talking with each other, is we learn from each other.